So we're at Muncie. We just won the Mento No Prep and got into the $250,000 race. We got rained out, so it moved back a couple weeks. It's going to give us a few more weeks of testing to see what it does. And we just made our first hit, and it went down good. Changed a little stuff and see if we can go faster. Went full tight on rebound because it was full loose. And we're going to see what it does. We're on the same tune.
How'd you like that one, bud?
Good. Went straight and fast, so I don't know what it went yet, but felt good. Yep, it was good.
Two passes. The goal is to make it four passes on these head gaskets. So two more, we're good to go.
Faster without turning it up, then you don't risk scattering your speed.
Oh, I'm just turning up the launch.
Oh, okay.
Not the, yeah, we just put 200
in. We put more tire pressure in it and leaving on a couple hundred more RPM.
Dropping a little bit, but it still
should
took
be
it.
Fast.
It still took it.
Should be fast.
Finally, it went kind of straight pretty much. Added a little bit of preload to the Caltrac bar. We were going left, so we got the anti-roll bar set up right, and then still went left, so added a little bit of preload to the Caltrac bar on the left side, and that pretty much drove me straight, I think, so. Hell yes!
It was smoking on the chip.
You don't risk scattering your speed.
Do you have a fire extinguisher?
I do.
Yeah, there's one right down there.
There's something. I don't know what that is. I hope your radiator's okay. I
hope my. You need the rotator out of your filled block.
What?
We scattered Austin's.
Oh, a little heavy's blown.
Ready?
Thank you.
getting squirrely.
Did it spin?
Oh, yeah, it spun. You spun. You got a squirrely probably 150.
No kidding. Yeah. It actually spun the tire?
Yeah, man. It hazed.
Huh. That's when you started getting those out there.
Yeah, when you started driving it.
Yep. Gotcha. Probably with the wheelie, it pulled timing, pulled power, and it unsettled everything. And then when it went back in, it just was... Okay. Yep. Got this bad boy back together. So this used to be an assembled, this motor the way it is now basically was together at one time in my Camaro. Back when it was non-intercooled and I was torching the head gaskets every other week, it felt like. So at the time I took it apart and just kind of had all the pieces laying around the shop since then. Well, when Austin hurt his motor, we were kind of looking for a solution to get him back up and going quickly. I told him, like, dude, we got all the parts right here, and we had good rods, good pistons, stuff that isn't going to blow out the bottom end after 9 passes again, probably. So he was all for it, and it works out good because it's going to give him like a good solid motor to go together and put in his car now. When he's done using it, I'm going to put it right back in my Camaro. Easy peasy. It's going to have all my oil pan and stuff on it anyways. It fits his car just the same. So it's kind of a win-win for both of us. But yeah, it's good to see it going back together. And it's one that Ron built for us back in the day. Good old Mike Duke heads on it. Got my Wagler rods in it. Just a 6.0 with Weisco pistons, but she's pretty bulletproof, so it's almost back together and ready to go.
One of the 9 passes, that's the goal.
10, if it goes 10, it's a win. So, yeah, we're almost there. She'll be running before we know it.